Who makes a good hair transplant candidate?
In our practice, we perform hair transplant for people whose hair loss has been stabilized. This is important since hair transplant surgery does not stop hair loss progression. It's important to understand that hair transplant, regardless of technique or technology, is a procedure limited by your hair loss progression and the hair you have in your donor area. Unfortunately, marketing of hair transplant tends to be deceptive about results and the number of transplants needed to obtain these results. In addition, the results of modern hair transplants referred to as FUEs or follicular unit extraction transplants are actually more limited than the results of follicular unit transplants or FUTs, also known as the strip method. Ironically, due to a combination of factors such as undesirable scars and hairstyles becoming shorter, the hair transplant industry has moved toward performing FUEs predominantly. The problem with FUEs is that the area of harvesting is wider and typically outside the true permanent zone, which means many grafts are at risk for thinning and balding. In addition, there is, in my opinion, an unacceptable rate of hair grafts being transected or being divided above the most important part of the hair graft, which is the root or the hair follicle. Conservatively, it has been reported that 30% of grafts can be transected. To address this limitation, technologies have been developed, such as the robot, to reduce this and other technical issues. This doesn't change the reality that the yield or coverage with so-called modern hair transplants is being compromised. To address the limitation of ongoing hair loss progression, we offer our male patients the option of taking finasteride or propecia, which is an oral medication that needs to be taken daily. Unfortunately, this drug has been associated in a small percentage of men to be associated with permanent sexual dysfunction. This unfortunate reality has been addressed in our practice with a new method of treating hair loss we've developed called hair regeneration. Briefly, hair regeneration is the application of advanced stem cell-based wound healing technology to stop hair loss and reverse thinning. With hundreds of patients who've come from around the world and 3 to 5 years of data proving the long-term benefit of one injection treatment, we have overcome the frustration people have with hair transplant surgery. Essentially, we've addressed progressive hair thinning, and by thickening your existing actively thinning hair, we've actually exceeded the results of any hair transplant surgery. From my perspective, the best candidate for a hair transplant is someone who desires hair in an area where there is long-standing hair loss after they've had their hair loss stabilized and reversed to their maximal potential.